What's the worst way you've seen someone publicly humiliated? 7th grade, tragically obese girl's desk broke slash fell apart slash exploded under her weight during class. Everyone erupted with laughter and immediately started making fun of her. I've never felt so bad for another person. She was very quiet and already picked on often. I'd never even talked to her, but, as she cried on all fours gathering her book and papers, I wanted to open a portal to a shameless paradise and shove her into it. A freshman girl at our high school was at the football game sitting in the bleachers a few rows in front of the majority of our class. Well, some guy she liked sat down a few feet from her on the same level of the bleacher. She decides to scoot across to sit next to him. Apparently she didn't know it was that time of the month, nor that she was wearing a miniskirt. She left a huge bloodstain from her original sitting point to her resting point. For the remaining 4 years she was known as Bloody Mary. My old boys' secondary school was in a densely populated part of London. One day we were all in the playground, I was about 15, about 600 or 700 kids, and a couple across the road were arguing, badly. The woman was screaming abuse from a third floor window, "You useless cheating prick. Go back to her then. Why are you even here?" And the man doing the classic, "Hey, come on. It weren't like that. And everything. Well, somebody from my year, we'll call him Lee, was watching, and laughing, openly." He then shouted something offensive at the woman. If memory serves, it was to the tune of "Shut up, you dirty slag," or similar. Anyway, the woman just disappeared from the window. Then an egg flew out. We watched transfixed, as it made a glorious arc straight into Lee's face. Now, this was a third floor window, and it went across a single lane road also. So this egg was really motoring. The sound of the impact was brutal. Lee's face was eggy and red from the impact, which deepened to a kind of magenta as he burst into tears. He was 15, but the shock just left him standing, bawling his eyes out. The teachers came, and then refused to believe that a woman had thrown an egg so far, and then just told him to go and clean himself up. He trailed off to the toilet, with the whole playground jeering and laughing. That's when I learned the meaning of hubris. TL, doctor, an egg on the face is worth two in the bush. 8th grade. It was an awkward time for most everyone. There's this one fat girl who wore shirts from Hot Topic that were too small for her and wore a million rubber bracelets. We were in the gym for an end of the year assembly. She was sitting at the top. As we were going down the bleachers to go outside, she trips over the seat in front of her and tumbles all the way down, landing on her back. Her shirt ridden up, showing her bulbous abdomen, right in front of her crush. She wasn't injured physically, but she was mentally, after everyone laughed at her. That girl was me. I wore sweatpants to school a lot in grade 6, despite my penis having a pubescent propensity to engorge itself at any available opportunity, and sweatpants offer very little boner stealth, if any. But they were comfortable and the cool thing to wear, so I did. I was constantly shuffling and shifting in an effort to hide my sprouting erections from the world, especially from my female classmates. One day, I'm wearing bright orange root sweatpants to school, which happened to be the same day that Ellen, who was both the cutest girl in the grade and the first one to develop, was assigned as my math partner. She wore this lip gloss that made her lips shine, and she had a bunch of jelly bracelets, and she was perfect. Just the mention of her name would make my little guy salute. So, understandably, working with her made all the blood rush to my dick. Thankfully, we were sitting at our desks, so my raging and turgid teenage boner wouldn't be discovered. Shouldn't have been, anyway. Because just as she leaned over, and I got a whiff of her strawberry-scented hair, I think her hair even brushed over my hand. Which was essentially like the Viagra for my 12-year-old self. The teacher called on me to answer the question on the board. I froze in my seat. I wasn't a bad kid. I couldn't tell the teacher no. My mind raced with possible outs, but I had none. I quickly pulled my t-shirt down, hoping I could stretch it to cover my crotch, and awkwardly and self-consciously arose to shuffle over to the board. It took less than 3 seconds for this kid Eric to stand up and point at my unavoidable boner, screaming, "He's got a woody. Look at his woody." It was like a scene from an 80s movie. The scene to establish empathy for the main character where the audio track of everyone laughing slows down, and the camera slowly zooms on the look of fear. The cringe-worthy scene that sets the tone for how bad the audience is supposed to feel for the protagonist. But this was no movie. This was real life. And kids can be cruel and have long memories. So, for the next 3 years, almost everyone started referring to me as Woody. Even some teachers. Maybe not the worst public humiliation ever. But for me, it was the end of the world. When I was in high school, we had two brothers that went to my school. To say they were beyond poor is the biggest understatement I can possibly fathom. The cool kids would give them change on a regular basis to do really, really horrible things. For instance, to lick an entire floor tile for a quarter. And they would do it without even thinking about it. They participated in a talent show my senior year by breakdancing, and literally everybody threw change up on the stage. They completely stopped and started picking it up. I've never been so ashamed of anything in my entire life, and I've had a lot of life behind me. To this day, I refuse to go to any of those fucking high school reunions, because all I can think about when I see those people is how they thought it was such a big fucking joke, while these two guys are fucking starving to death. About 15 years ago, one of the brothers was found in a train tunnel that runs through my hometown, died of exposure. I have no idea about the other one. I keep getting requests on Facebook from the guys that did it the most, real estate agents, moms with kids, etc, and I get so angry tears leak out of my face. I was at a music festival in a park. Everyone, including me, was pretty wasted. About 20 feet in front of the stage, some drunk dude pushes everyone back so that an empty circle in the crowd forms. I think he was hoping it would be like in one of those breakdancing movies. The ones where everyone stands around in a circle while someone busts out some crazy moves and everyone is impressed. So, he's got his space. He dives down into what was supposed to be the opening moves of the worm. Hands and head first, feet in the air still. He went down. He didn't come back up. I guess his upper body strength was lacking that day. Instead of pushing himself back up, he just planted his face into the cigarette butt covered wet grass and mud, nearly breaking his wrists in the process. He laid there for about half a minute as about 200 people laughed their asses off. Even the lead singer noticed him. He was singing, and didn't skip a beat. Blah blah holy shit dude. Blah blah. Eventually, he got up. He looked like he had shit on his face, he had a cut lip, and he had broke his sunglasses. Ashamed, he stumbled through the crowd and left. Also, that drunk dude was me. I've since decided that I should lose some weight and maybe start working on my upper body before I try the worm again. Sixth grade, recess time. I was a fat kid and these two girls were making fun of me. Random bird shits on the meanest girl's head. It was a fat load of shit. The bird must have been an eagle. It hit her in the forehead, went down her face, and off of her chin, and got on her shirt and pants. A bit of it actually got in her mouth. There was basically a line of it from her forehead to her knee, with random gaps here and there. I started laughing instantly, and she burst into tears. I seized the opportunity and immediately started yelling as loud as I could that she just got crapped on by a bird. She ran away crying, and never fucked with me again. One time when I was in high school, someone called in a bomb threat. The entire school, 500 plus people, was waiting out front for the okay to go back inside when these two very large black girls started fighting. During the fight, one girl got her shirt and bra ripped off. Big floppy titties flying everywhere. The other girl proceeds to drag the topless girl across the grass by her hair until it finally detached from her head. It was fake. At this point, the girl with the upper hand walks away with her wad of hair, waving it around like a pom-pom. The half-naked chick just laid on the ground crying in the fetal position. I have never felt so bad for anyone in my life. The principal helps her up and gives her his coat to cover up while she walked through the crowd of cackling hideous. It was brutal. Saw a husband and wife in the mall. The guy looked absolutely miserable. Downcast eyes, slumped shoulders and a shuffling gait. I was trying not to stare, but something about him was just, I had to look. His wife starts snapping at him. Hold this, give me your credit card, I'm buying this. He mumbled something about his credit card and she screeches, oh my god, what Tim? You're such a fucking pussy. Give me that credit card now. I deserve these shoes for having to deal with you and your tiny baby dick. You're such a piece of shit. If you don't want me to tell everyone how you can't get hard and cry, you'll give it to me now. Tim, wherever you are, I'm so sorry, bro. 8th grade earth sciences class. We had a teacher who had a notoriously bad comb over. Had the thing hairsprayed on to where it looked like a shitty helmet. He has one kid who's a notorious smart ass up front helping him demonstrate something in an experiment. While the teacher is looking at the class, the kid grabs a yardstick and uses it to push the teacher's comb over helmet a good 8 inches off of his head. Teacher, eeii. Smart ass student, sorry, I had to know. Whole class fucking lost it. I was MC at an event where someone had set up a very elaborate proposal to his longtime girlfriend in front of hundreds of people. I knew the guy, and it was a favor to him, but even I could detect it was a bad idea because they had a very rocky relationship. Still, I went through with it. Shocked and upset, she said no, leaving him on one knee in a silly outfit, and after a long and beautiful speech, a very uncomfortable silence followed, and he struggled to get up, fell over, and then got up and briskly walked back to his hotel room. Later that night, she said she never wanted to see him again. Damn, I wish I'd seen this sooner, because I really want high school teachers to see it. Worst public humiliation was my own, at the hands of my chemistry teacher. I got pregnant my junior year. Yeah. Broken family, abused, daddy issues. Typical stupid girl with more drama in her life than sense. Nonetheless, I fucked up, and I know that. Don't judge me. Before class one day, my teacher overhears another student ask me if I was keeping the baby, and me telling them yes. When he heard this, he went apeshit. He spent the next 30 minutes berating me. He asked me how much I thought I could make at a minimum wage job. He asked me how much baby items cost. He then proceeds to write a budget on the blackboard in front of everyone. In chemistry, getting pregnant in high school is awful. People treat you like shit. You can't go out in public because the looks and comments make you want to cry. You lose friends. Family disowns you. It's scary and humiliating enough as it is, and this educator made an example of me in front of all my peers. He told me and everyone else I'd have to go on welfare and leech off of everyone else. My senior year I worked 3 jobs. I never took a penny of government money. I graduated. I went to college. My daughter is a smart, caring, responsible, mature kid who never gets in trouble and is an honor student. Sort of a weird one, but most of the kids I rode the school bus with in middle school really didn't like this one girl for whatever reason. We had assigned seats and Noon was assigned to sit with her. Everyone around her just made fun of her. For a while she had been complaining about the bus stinking and everyone chalked it up to her being a bitch. To make things more interesting, the bus barn or wherever belonged to one of the kids' moms and our bus was always just parked at her house. Turns out, her kid and his friends had been pissing on her seat every day at home and letting it dry. We all found out the day he decided to announce it to her when she woke up from sleeping w her face against the seat. I saved the potential worst moment of this kid's life in middle school. He was the quiet weird kid nobody talked to. We were in band class, and we are both percussionists, so we stand in the back of the class. I look over, and he had pissed his jeans so bad there was a puddle under his feet. He sat there for a second thinking of how to get out of the situation. Without thinking, I take my Gatorade, 32 ounce freshly open, and dump it on his stomach, completely soaking him from the belly button down. I made a big spectacle like, oh man, my bad, it just spilled. You better go to the nurse to get cleaned up or something like that. Band teacher was pissed at first, but then realized what I did. To this day, we are the only ones that knows what happened. 3 stories. A girl who I hated in Form 1 had a giant wet blood patch on the back of her light blue school dress. I walked up behind her and did the womanly duty of letting her know and then giving her my jumper to tie around her waist. She never thanked me. In primary school, a rather large boy was always trying to make friends with the wrong people, was being teased. He fell on his back, kinda like a turtle. He couldn't get back up. He cried, then farted, then laughed. I don't think he ever lived it down. Myself, the first time I ever asked to go steady with someone, He turned around and yelled at me in front of what felt like the entire school and said, "You are the ugliest girl I've ever seen. I will never date you." He asked me out 3 years later. Jokes on him. Asshole. In the 6th grade, we went on field trip to see Romeo and Juliet at the community theater. I think there were about 100 kids there. It's boring. Romeo is just going on and on about what an angel this bitch is, and all of a sudden, the reveal. Juliet walks out, and she's a good 280. I remember hearing that rustling sound of rising disquiet in the audience, her huge thumping steps, giggling, teachers hissing at aisle kids in fear. I felt sick for the rest of the play. The anxiety was too much for me. I was just a boy. I wanted to die. It turned out that everyone behaved themselves. Until the end. Romeo is dead in the middle of the stage. Juliet flails around in tears, monologuing her heart out. Suddenly she thrusts the dagger into her enormous bosom and drops to her knees over Romeo's body. The theater is quiet. Before she collapses slowly onto her lover's body and squeezes a final line out of Romeo. Oomph. It might have still gone okay if the kid in front of me hadn't yelled out, "You're killing him." The curtains closed to pandemonium. Back in college, I was a bartender at one of the wilder establishments downtown. Women often danced on the bar, and it was not uncommon for a few pairs of boobs to be flashed around. Anyway, this extremely intoxicated girl was dancing on top of the bar wearing a very short white skirt, and the whole place could see her ass. The song ends, she hops down from the bar, and disappears. I see her a few songs later on top of the bar again, gyrating and flailing along with the music, only now on her ass in permanent marker is scrawled, "Jake was here." She had no idea. I was in 11th grade, and I had math class with a fucking jerk. The typical big boy attractive baseball player with a big ego. You know the type. Well, one day he made fun of me for something. I can't remember what it was exactly. Everyone snickered like they always did, and my face turned red. With a very serious look, I stared him straight in the eye, and said calmly, "Do you wake up every morning and say, 'Today, I'm going to be a doucher bag,' or does it just come naturally?" The teacher, who was a very soft-spoken woman in her 60s, looked at the entire class, and says, "I think it just comes naturally for him." He never said anything mean to anyone in the class again after that.